want you to think of all the Minecraft updates you have played through. And now, I want you to think of your least favorite of those updates. If you own a server, maybe it was 1.8 because of the EULA. Or if you're a PvP person, it was probably 1.9 because from then onwards, there's a hit cooldown on all weapons. But if you're me, your least favorite update is 1.15. I think it should never have been released. Here is why. Development for 1.15 began in August with snapshot 19W34A, and the latest version is 1.15.2, which was released on January 1st, 2020, and appears to be the final version of 1.15. Throughout all of these updates, these are the major changes. Firstly, bees. And with bees comes beehives, bee nests, honey blocks, honeycomb blocks, honey bottles, and honeycombs. Maybe this seems like a lot, but consider all of these items come down to one feature. And secondly, a lot of small tweaks to the game, and a lot of bug fixes. 304 to be exact. I'm not here to completely hate on 1.15 and be super biased, so 304 may seem like a large number of bugs, but take this with a grain of salt, because 1.13, a well-respected update, fixed 384 bugs. 1.8, 426. So the real kicker here is how little it added in the time span of development. In 4 months, what was added again? Bees. Only bees. Bugs were removed. And by the way, I think the name Bugs and Bees is better than Buzzy Bees, because to the consumer who doesn't pay attention to Minecraft updates, it looks like the update brought more. Anyway. One feature set was added. Even 1.10, which, please excuse me mentioning it a lot in the next few minutes, is also a really small update, so it's good to compare. Restarting my sentence. Even 1.10, the Frostburn update, which added slightly more than 1.15, only took a month to make, not four. And even when an update has a theme, there are still other items that are added. For example, phantoms in 1.13, and bamboo in 1.14. 1.15 is the only update that won't make changes to gameplay, besides honey blocks for redstoners. But since all existing farms work super efficiently already, what's the point? Making piston doors? Maybe. Again, referring to 1.10, magma blocks heavily influence modern mob farm designs. Igloos, though rare, come in really useful in the early game, if you can find one. And an overlooked change is that firework rockets were made 3 times cheaper. Useful for the late game, right? Basically, what I'm saying right now is 1.15 is a tiny, tiny update. But why does it matter? Bees are truly cute and they're doing no harm to the game. Well, that's not what this is about. I'm upset for 2 reasons. Firstly, because of the modding done to the game, Minecraft is never truly fully updated. Certain plugins, mods, resource packs, and external tools will be discontinued. Others will take a long time to be updated. When 1.13 Update Aquatic was released, it took 213 days or 7 months for Forge to be released, which, if you're not familiar with, is the current standard for loading mods. Optifine, the FPS mod everyone uses, took 100 days to be updated, or 3 months. But these long wait times were worth the amount of features brought to Minecraft with Update Aquatic. Back to 1.15. Right now, as of March 5th, Optifine for 1.15 is still in its beta form, meaning certain features such as shaders are not yet supported, and Optifine is generally buggy. Luckily, that's about it in terms of major mods, plugins, tools, and packs. And that's what my big grudge with 1.15 is. People won't be able to play with shaders for now. But even worse, people on old or underpowered machines will get, at best, decent frame rates on the lowest settings, and at worst, the game will be unplayable. I did mention there was a second reason. It's quite simple. A Minecraft update that took 4 months and added one minor feature set is a huge red flag for the future of the game. After many minor updates, people will leave the game. And I don't want that for Minecraft.